Welcome back. We're going to play this game. Assuming that I can remember still how to play it. Oh, it says I've cleared the game. Check that out. Let's try... Oh, nice. We can try Spectre Knight. We can even try Plague Knight. It says this is the tricky alternate quest. Whereas the Spectre Knight campaign is a tragic prequel. I will say that I have seen people... Oh, check that out. I have to register a name still. Hopefully it's not going to be a problem that I use the same name. Also, I could probably have typed this in on the keyboard. Here we go. Tragic prequel. I have seen large parts of other people play this. Long ago, the lands were untamed and roamed by legendary adventurers. But although the land is peaceful, for some, freedom is a far-gone memory. Spectre Knight, servant to the Enchantress, has been given a harrowing task. He must recruit a group of knights and form an invincible order. With each member gathered, treasure keepsake grows in power. Artifact that can restore his humanity, but only when his task is complete. Oh wow. Now he leaves the confines of the Tower of Fate. It's time for the Reaper to pursue his quarry. Wow, I never realized just how tragic this was. Darkness. I thought this prequel did have somewhat of a lighter tone than it actually does have. Oh, interesting. So, yeah, these game mechanics do take some learning here. Like, you can't, like, climb a wall indefinitely. Climb up that much and then he automatically jumps off and tries to reconnect to the wall. But each time he loses just a little bit, and you can't climb up the green walls either. Just the exposed just rock walls are the ones you can climb. Wait, so how am I supposed to get up here? Oh, that's okay. Interesting. He's got a different hurt box. I would say hit box. I don't know. Presumably his hit box is also different, but certainly his hurt box of what he is able to hit differs from Shovel Knight. It's much more extended reach. Okay, there's nothing up there. That's too bad. Okay, can I collect this thing? Okay. Oh, hey, look, I got it. Nice. Okay, and then points out the mechanic of, the jumping on the sand blocks, you destroy them. This is an excellent tutorial, I gotta say. Check this out. Yeah, I've seen other people show that you can do that. It still looks pretty cool. No matter how many times you see it. Oops. Wait, what? Ah, there we go. Alright, let's destroy this checkpoint. Assuming it can be destroyed still. Wait, is this an indestructible checkpoint? I'm impressed. No, we gotta keep hacking this until it gets destroyed, right? I guess apparently in the tutorial level they give you an indestructible checkpoint. This is news. News to me that the game could even have such a thing. Nice. Oh, that's interesting how you can jumping right into it. Now, arguably, maybe I could have somehow damage boosted right through him. I'm not sure. Oh. Okay. I want to time this right now, don't I? Oh, that's awesome how, unlike Shovel Knight, I can actually dive into enemies and hit them. Yeah, Spectre Knight's gonna be fun to play. If I can get used to the fact that certain edges can be climbed and certain edges cannot. Yeah, I'm gonna enjoy this a lot better than if I can't grasp that. Okay. Oh, hang on. There we go. There's a hidden path here, right? Oh boy. Wait, can I collect this? Alright, now let's not mess that up. Nice. Alright. And... ha! Had to collect each last thing there. Oh, apparently I can't land on an enemy to hit them, though. I have to actually be diving. Oops. Green slime's gonna ruin my day here. Come here, green slime. There we go. Oh, check that out. Did not expect to find a hidden secret, even in the training level. There's my turkey. I think we're getting the hang of this. And just as I say that, the game steps up the difficulty. Okay. Wait, is there something over there? No, we're gonna leave that gold behind. There's nothing over there. Is there anything to the left? Nope. Alright. There is a hidden path on the right here, although hidden hardly describes it. I hesitate, but... alright. Nice. Okay, it's just barely high enough that he can't make that jump. Oops. Okay. So he needs to be gaining altitude at the time he hits that. jeez. Ah, shit. I deserve that. I so deserve that. Well, alright, so let's ignore that path on the right, only because there's some mechanic I have not fully mastered. And I don't have the presence of mind to figure it out at the moment. Hang on. Let's collect these, though. Oh! I saw two gems in a row, and I'm thinking, man, this is a pretty nice haul here. And then just an enemy pops out of nowhere. Oh, okay. There's a treasure over there. Wait, can he climb this wall indefinitely? No. Every wall has the same limitation. There we go. This makes up for me dying earlier. We'll say. It really doesn't, but we'll say it does. Okay. Wait, what? What is this? Willful Wisp prolongs your undeath by increasing max will. Nice! Yeah, I'll accept that. That's way more important than however much gold I want to collect. Does this dragon thing show up again if I... yeah. There we go. Okay. Nice. Wait, what's this? Okay, that's just a skull, apparently. Whoops. Whoopsie daisy. Can I damage boost through him? Yeah, there we go. Go. Ah, shite. Ah, that hurts. Okay, so... yeah, I'm not sure I'm going to be able to complete this tutorial level unless I can master that mechanic. What's the difference between him diving and leaping? I still don't get it. Ah. You can gain altitude up to a point there. So, okay. This is the point where I died last time, and I don't understand why. Oh, I get it. You have to wait until you're at the right altitude to hit the thing. Alright, that would have been good to understand earlier. So much for not having the presence of mind. The game forced me to figure it out, even if I was a little hesitant to keep going at it. Got another gem here. Yeah, I was wondering where... how it was that he was seeing all these little cross things. Oh, this is how I get back to the other path. Well, I'm feeling adventurous. Don't know why. There we go. Oh, I thought there was a different path that this joined up with. Apparently not. There we go. Well, that was ambitious. That was ambitious for sure. he's doing a little moonwalk out of this section of the stage. There we go. Yeah, but if I pay attention to those little animations, that's different than any other game I've played. This one, you can actually see how he's going to move before he moves. Every other platformer I've seen, anyway. Now, what voice did I give Black Knight? I don't remember. It's been too long. Halt! These foul lands are no place for commoners. Turn back, whoever you are. Fool, I've come here for you. You will kneel before me, bow before the Enchantress, and join her order. Your cutting words are no match for my cutting blows. I'll teach you a lesson in humility. Come, Terrapin, my shelled steed. Oh, wow. That's cool. You know, I suppose that this kind of harkens back to Mega Man-like bosses, and that with practice, you can learn all these patterns that were very intelligently planned into the game. Or you could just button mash, and sometimes get away with it. Nice! Very cool. That fighting style, could it be Donovan? But you were claimed by the tower.
The tower grows in power each moment. The Enchantress has plans for you, and will grant you what you desire.
I won't be led astray. You standing before me means there's hope for the one I seek. I'm glad you're safe, Donovan, but keep your distance. The Donovan I knew surely knew better than to pursue me further.
All right, so, prologue. Oh wait, I was gonna transition out of this, but yeah. Prologue chapter 0 complete, we'll say. All right, the Enchantress, I need to give her a voice.
So, you've returned. I assume Black Knight has joined Narrax.
Neither words nor scythe had any effect. The fool persists in some fruitless quest.
Indeed, it seems I'm dealing only with fools here. Was I a fool to trust you? Tarry here no longer. For your sake, pray that the others are less obstinate. Bring the knights in.
You notice I do this thing with the voices that doesn't make sense. Anyway, I think it's amusing. Probably other people think it's ridiculous. Oh, this must be some sort of castle stage where you're able to talk with folks. So, is this the bard? Ah. Even 100 of them. I beg you, please bring them all to me. Oh wow. Okay, so we can throw a boomerang blade, unleash a powerful close-range strike, clutch this- ooh, that's gonna save my bacon. So I think, we'll deal without the boomerang blade for a while. Oh. Never mind. We have a little training course here. Ha ha. Okay, tread carefully. Unleash a powerful close range strike. Oh, I see. Wait, how do I unleash this? I see myself charging up with it. and I hit you while I'm charged. Yeah, I don't get it. How do I use this? I might be dying here. Okay, yeah, that didn't quite work so well. Oh, there we are. So yeah, my scythe is disabled, but I can use this. If I push the correct button. That's cool. Oh, I cannot climb the pink walls either. Okay, I missed out on that gold, but more importantly, I appear to be stuck, period. So how do I get out of here? I can't jump back onto the wall here. Oh, I see. There we go. I found the one way to get trapped in the training level. That curious no more mere bauble. Alright, can we get one more, please? Yeah, let's get this. Oh, we're down to two. Never mind, though. We're done shopping. Perhaps I'll make an offering. Sure, why not? Okay. Why not? Sure. We'll see where this leads in the next episode. Oh, there we go. We got something out of this. Maybe. State your business. Who are you? We are Manny. We like your cloak. Huh. Alright. Oh, I see. So, I've purchased the ability to purchase cloaks. I guess we're sticking with, the Crimson Cloak. At least until I can stop dropping all my gold. Wisp. Okay. Darkness Wisps are Clockwork Tower Explodatorium or Lickyard. Alright, so I don't suppose, yeah, there's nothing for me to acquire there. Yeah, let's not go there right yet. Let's save that for next episode. We want to spoil everything all at once now, would we? This is our Gastronomer. Bone Clang, huh. Ground of Justice on me. Oh, come on. Could you please give me just a tiny bit more? 2985. That's not enough to purchase a new cloak. Is not enough to purchase a new cloak. Fine. Whatever. Yeah, so... empty pockets. Only 985 gold. Oh, check that out. Huh. 131 is the number of walls you scale. The number of times you've fallen in battle is 3. Total time you spent is 24 minutes. The number of dash slashes is 133. Yeah, whatever. Of course you're not a mirror. You're a scrying glass. Huh. So you remember that one little gold bar I said we can ignore safely and I don't have to worry about it and didn't have the presence of mind to go collect it? That one gold bar is making the difference between me being able to do nothing and being able to do something here. Wait, can I bash this dude? Can you give me gold? Hmm. Alright. Wait, is there nothing up here? Why would you make this area and then not put anything up there? Clearly that's a hidden secret. But there's no hidden secret there. Anyway. Yeah. I think we've learned the basics of Spectre Knight. Let's go, continue this next time. So, thanks for watching, and see you then.